Yo, hey, what's up, guys? It's February 8th, 2014, and I figured I want to go ahead and make a quick little video, or maybe a long video, who knows, of pretty much stuff that I picked up over the past 2 weeks. I picked this up today. There we go. And it's the Avengers, number 57. All of you comic book collectors know what this is. It's the first appearance of Vision. And I picked this up for a really, really nice price. I mean, I was really surprised. Like, how much are you selling it for? Is it fake? You know, is it a reproduction? Or is it from China? Or is there water staining? But no, the condition, I would say, it's probably about a very good condition. The only main eyesores, I would say, of this comic book are the rust stains on the staples. Right there. And where's the other one? Oh, right there. There's a little brown staining from the staples. Other than that, you know, there's just type of, you know, dents and dings. Nothing really too major. No torn pages. So I would have to put this at a very good condition. But I'm really happy in the price that I paid for this. And truth be told, I'm probably going to add this to my collection or see how much it rises. It grows in price when the Avengers 2 movie comes out. Because then I may end up selling it or trading it. I don't know, but I'm really glad I have that. So for you comic book collectors out there, yep, I'm still buying comic books. But as you can tell, out of these figures that I bought, only one comic book kind of tells you, okay, out of, what, like 10 or 8 things I buy of vintage toys, I'll buy one comic book per 10 things. Who knows? But that kind of gives you an idea where my main emphasis is. But don't get me wrong, I'm still doing comic books, guys. So I'm glad I picked that up. I picked this up at my collector's marketplace. And it's a vintage 1985, I believe, Snowcat. G.I. Joe original Snowcat. Now, when I picked this up, I picked it up at a pretty good price. And the thing that I went to go get, I don't know how I'm going to show you because of the camera. It came with a box. The box is pretty much complete. There's, you know, your average wear and tear. But the reason why I have it like this is because I'm trying to flatten out the box. The box was in pretty rough shape. You know, it had its kind of its disformality. It was a little disformed here and there. You know, nothing really major, like I said, guys. Both side of the flaps are there. It's just I have it like this, and I'm having it actually placed under my mattress or between my bed mattress. I'm probably going to leave it there for like maybe about a month with hopes that it will flatten out and become nice and straight with my fat butt. Hopefully it does a job because it's a really nice box. And I don't know if a lot of you guys know, but the Snowcat, it's really hard to come by with the box and that's nothing cut out. Pretty much the file card and the G.I. Joe points are still there. Every box that I've come across, either on eBay, yard sales, private sales on Facebook or other forums, these have always been cut out. So I was really happy, really glad to find out that these aren't removed, and because, you know, I want to add it to my collection. So it's kind of, I guess I'm starting to collect G.I. Joes with the boxes only and with these points in the file card not cut out. If they're cut out, I don't buy it. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being a little picky, but I want my collection to be like that. But anyways, I picked this up. Hopefully in a month, I'll show you guys in a video in a month from now to see how much it flattened out. Hopefully it did the job, but you can tell there's a bend, you know, it's kind of, you know, a little bend there, and then on the other side too, more so. And one thing I did notice, I'm still debating whether or not if I should do it, but on most of these G.I. Joe vehicles, they have a window, and the window has a type of see-through plastic film or cutout opening. And I've noticed that this plastic, I'm like, hey, I felt and seen this type of plastic before, even though it's really thin. I'm like, what? Mylar. It's a Mylar type bag, and you all know me, guys. I love my Mylar. I would have to say this is probably a 1 mil type Mylar in here. So I'm debating whether or not I'll show you here in a bit another G.I. Joe box, but the ones that have been pretty much torn. They've broken through. They're falling apart. Taking the old Mylar out, cutting up a comic book Mylar bag, and then getting like some cement glue or that rubbery type glue, or maybe even a glue stick, and then gluing inside the box, and then putting the Mylar, so this way it's a nice newer type of a window there. Will it deface the value? Probably, but versus the boxes that either have none, or maybe that are all torn and broken, maybe it'll bring the value up. I'm not sure, but again, those are my collection, so I'll show you here in a bit what I'm talking about. But anyways, I'm like, hey, that's Mylar. I can probably do that. Anyways, moving on, guys. So, like I was mentioning before, picked this snow cat up for a pretty affordable price, and I'm really glad. I'm really happy with it. It's in really nice condition. One thing I do want to share with you guys, a lot of you G.I. Joe goers out there, collectors, know that this snow cat, the window, does get dirty. There's usually a lot of scratches, a lot of fading because of the plastic. And this, excuse me, this window wiper here. Man, I got burps. This window wiper here, you know, the kids usually, you know, go back and forth, or if it's tossed around or put in a certain way, this ends up scratching the window. One thing I just realized, like, hey, it's plastic, kind of see-through. Let me do an experiment. And what I did was I used car wax. Let me show you. Now, a lot of people have their own tricks and methods of getting this plastic clear again. But one thing, I'm like, hey, I don't want to replace the window. I don't want to buy a replica. I wanted it to keep it at least somewhat pristine and original, vintage. So I use this, the Meguiar's rubbing compound. It's meant for cars, of course, for, you know, for cleaning out and scratches and abrasions on your vehicle's paint. But it's pretty much the same type of formula almost to work on this type of plastic. And sure enough, it did. I put just a smidge of it on my finger. I rubbed it around. And just like car wax, you have to let it dry. I let it sit and dry for about maybe, I would say about a minute. I didn't want to get to a point where it's completely, you know, stuck and all hard like mud, like dry mud. No, it was still a little liquefied a little bit. So as soon as it, you know, got nice and firm, I got a wet towel and I started just stroking, just rubbing it. Just rubbing all of the wax off. And sure enough, I don't want to say it's 100% see-through, because normally it never was, but it's much better. It's not clouded. Now, with some of you guys out there with vehicles that have clouded headlights, like, hey, it's turning kind of yellowish. You know, the headlights are kind of clouded inside. They're not so see-through as like when I bought the car brand new. That's because of oxidation and, of course, you know, environment, weather, and so forth. Same principle with this. This isn't your type of plastic type rubbing compound, but it still did the job. If it didn't, if it screwed up, my fault, but it didn't. It did a really good job. I did it on the inside. I did it on the outside, of course, of the glass or the plastic. And it looks pretty much almost brand new. There's no clouding. You can still see little scratches. It's not perfect, but that's okay because it's still a vintage toy. You know, it's 30 years old or almost 30 years old. So I wanted to keep that. Anyways, I just wanted to share that with you guys. This is what I got. It worked. Again, just spread it around, use a damp cloth, wiped it off, rubbed it in, and boom, it was good as new or almost new. So yeah. Anyways, everything else on this vehicle was pretty nice, pretty cool. Even the tabs here, both the tabs on this little missile launcher aren't broken, which is really rare, hard to find too. Usually those are broken. Missiles are either missing, and then plus this is sometimes broken too on the window wiper. But other than that, it's really nice. The only thing I'm kind of, I don't want to say disappointed, but I'm probably going to get rid of or use for spare parts is this guy right here. I believe it's Frostbite is his name. Yep, Frostbite. He's not really in the kind of condition that I normally purchase or collect. As you can tell, there's some wear. Let's see if we can get this to focus here. On his gun, there's some wear. On his beard, on the top of his hat, there's some paint wear. Other than that, it's in pretty nice shape. There's his belt, kind of some paint wear on there. But again, it's not really up to my type of standards. So I'll probably just use them for spare parts. And as you can tell here, I wanted to show you, I have a bag of just parts of kind of like a Jeffrey Dahmer type, Jeffrey Dahmer type situation of parts, huh? I know I shouldn't have said that, but anyways, you get the idea. Just there's heads, there's legs, there's torsos, different types of screws. Whenever there's a, say, a character I buy, and let's say I buy another one to replace, you know, his chest or his head, I'll take it apart, replace it with the, you know, to make a nice, complete, minty figure, and all the other parts I'll put in here. You know, like, for example, I don't know if you can tell, but there's some screws in there for the back. The back screws and even the leg screws are sometimes different, sometimes a little bit longer or shorter, so there's different types of screws, and I try to keep them all together. And plus file cards. File cards, I keep them in here. I don't really associate or collect file cards with the Joes, only because I try to collect my G.I. Joes, number one, minty, and with the either mint on card, or at least with the full back card, you know, like I showed in my other videos, where it has the full card, the full back, I collect those. So anything else I'll put in here. If you guys are looking for parts or file cards, hit me up, let me know. So I wanted to show that to you. Another thing, guys, that I picked up besides this this snow cat here was this guy. Now forgive me, guys, for a second, his name escapes me. I don't know if this is Ricondo or Leatherneck. I just forgot. I'm sorry, guys. Just doing this video sometimes. I forget things. Anyways, I picked him up, guys, off of eBay for pretty cheap. I'm pretty happy. However, again, when I'm getting him, he's not up to spec for my collection. There's some paint wear, again, on his grenades, on his chest, on his knife. And that's pretty much it. Everything else is nice and neat. It's just, I don't know, that on his chest. Oh, his mustache is little nicked, and I don't know. It's just like when you're buying comic books or buying figures, they have to be a certain way for your collection because everything else is. And once you get that one figure that's just slightly under your grading bar, it's like, we'll, I don't know, we'll keep it for parts. And then plus his gun is pretty messed up on his handle, as you can tell. I don't know, that's just me being a little anal. But I'll probably end up keeping him for parts. I'll probably find another one, hopefully with a better chest and head. And then I'll just switch out parts if need be. And the gun I'll just keep for parts in case any of my friends or anyone out there needs his gun and doesn't really care about the condition. But I'll send it to you. With that same buyer, I ended up buying this guy right here, Frostbite. He's in really nice condition. He's a little dirty here and there. I plan on cleaning him up, taking him apart, cleaning his arms and his back and his joints, because there's some dirt or some type of staining. Not yellowing or sun staining, but I don't know, looks like maybe somebody was eating like maybe a burrito and some beans got on him. I hope that's beans. I have no idea, but it's on his hat. I don't know if the camera can pick it up, on his belt, but I'll end up cleaning him out eventually. But I picked him up also. These ones, like I said, on eBay, if you guys are interested in collecting G.I. Joes, I picked these up for like, I think, like $6 each. Pretty affordable. So, yeah, I'm just adding them to my collection. So, except for him, of course. Another one that I picked up off of eBay, it's not G.I. Joe related, but it is a small little action figure, which is this Boba Fett. This is the original 1979 Boba Fett figure, and it's 100% complete, and it's in really nice condition. All the ones that I've seen, either at trade shows, conventions, or even eBay, there is a lot of paint wear on his chest. There's a lot of markings. His mask is all missing paint, the red paint and such. And this one, I wanted a nice one, so I took my time and finally found one for a reasonable price. And of course, he does have his original gun in here. And everything seems to be attached. There's his missile, of course. Little paint wear back there behind his booster. But other than that, that's pretty much it, guys. And I picked this up for, I think I picked this up for like maybe $30 or under $30. His belt's really nice. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. Another thing, guys, I picked up As you can tell here, I picked up, let me see if I can focus in on it, zoom in, this He-Man Modulok. Now on this one, I have a nice story to tell on it. Now I picked this up at my local collector's market, and I paid a little bit too much for it, but that's okay. Now being a collector and buyer and seller of these vintage toys, it's nice to get to know people, talk to other collectors, just kind of build a little friendship with them, you know, kind of an association with them. Like, hey, you know, yeah, this guy has this. Hey, I know Rick, he does this. Or, hey, I know this other person, go with him, he sells this. So it's kind of nice to build that type of trust and communication, kind of a friendship, if you want to say. Now, I believe I paid $75 for this. It's not mint in box, it's not sealed, it is opened. However, let me see if I can open it here for you guys. This was one of my favorite He-Man action figures when I was little. I remember getting this and I would spend hours trying to come up with different designs, different characters, because this right here, being it's a He-Man character, you can take his pieces apart and build and put together kind of like a Lego type action figure. You can build your own character out of the parts that come along with this toy here, and let me show you. Oh yeah, it also came with this really cool diagram, kind of giving the kids an idea of pretty much how to build, what to make, you know, how to put together your Modulok character. Okay, you can make it into some type of snake or serpent creature. You can put four arms on this creature. It's pretty cool, and turn it around. And if you bought two Moduloks, you can make like a super monster. You know, you can pretty much build that monstrosity of a toy. Now, don't tell me that would be cool if you took that to school or showed your friends back in 1985, 1986. Like, dang, what kind of toy is that? What do you have? Right? So, that's what I'm talking about. Anyways, I might actually probably pick up two loose ones on eBay. They go for pretty cheap. I probably pick them up for under 20 bucks. You know, complete, loose, and try to build this type of funny-looking character. I think that's pretty cool. I think I'm going to do it. Expect a video on that. Anyways, back to this. So this is it right here. Now, again, these packages are opened. On the back side, they're slid open, and of course the parts, you can take them out of the bags and put together. But I left them as this. You know, it looks a little bit nicer, a little bit cleaner, and kind of gives you an idea what it looked like before taking them out of the package. And as you can tell, there's the two heads and the torso and the arms. And that's pretty cool. And that's how it came inside the box. And then in the box also came with its famous He-Man comic book. It's little mini He-Man comic book. Anyways, back to this, guys. Sorry, hope you guys didn't get bored. But you know, anyone that looks out for me, and when he's selling something, hey, Rick, I really want 75 for it, you know? All right, done, man. You've looked out for me, you've taken care of me, I'll give you your 75. Even though I know I can get this cheaper, but it's going to be my collection, it's a nice piece. I don't mind paying that 75 bucks. So again, guys, keep that in mind. You know, it's always good to make friendships and kind of that trust in either comic book collecting or even toy collecting. You know, you don't want to try to rip off or take advantage of people that look out for you, because then they stop looking out for you and they don't want to be your friend. You know, like, oh, well, there's Rick, you know, he's an asshole, whatever. But I didn't want to be like that. So I paid a little bit more, but that's okay. And again, talking about these little comic books, guys, I picked up a few more there. They had a nice stack of comic books or these He-Man. This Roboto I picked up a while ago from the same guy that sold me that Modulok. I would say maybe 3 or 4 months back. But I was finally able to find there at the store Roboto's original comic book. Now, Roboto was my all-time favorite He-Man character. All-time favorite. I love this guy. This is a really nice figure, especially his boots. It's hard to come around having his boots be still with silver paint. the silver paint, I remember, would fade, or even if you kept it in the sun for too long and in heat, it would start to become sticky and the paint would fall off and you would leave fingerprints. I remember my original one that I had and I ended up throwing it away, but this is a really nice piece. So anyways, I got his comic book, and then plus I got Skeletor's original comic book in here also. And yeah, they're pretty hard to find, guys, believe it or not. You know, on eBay, the original ones, the first series comic books of He-Man, plan on spending about $20 just for this little, that little type of comic book, especially the first series of He-Man, Skeletor, and whatnot. Yeah, they're pretty expensive. So yeah, got those. Next thing, guys, I want to show you, I picked up this Transformer here, 1984 Sunstreaker. These Lamborghini-type vehicles, these cars, were my all-time favorite. Now, this is my second boxed, or, well, my third one. The first one that I had was of Sideswipe. Sideswipe was part of my original Transformer collection about 10 years ago. I never sold it, reason because it's a Lamborghini. I loved Lamborghinis when I was little. So I decided to pick up this one also about a week ago from the collector's market. Picked this up at a decent price. And one thing I want to show you guys, hopefully you guys are still watching my video here, but I tend to keep my vehicles, my Transformers, in Mylar. Yeah, believe it or not, oh, there's Rick again putting Mylar everywhere in his video. And the reason why for that, guys, I'm so addicted to Mylar is because just the chemical properties of Mylar. I mean, it doesn't fade, it won't dissolve. It's just a really nice thing, or at least bag, to preserve your comic books or anything vintage. And I'm really worried because of these boxes, right? Or these boxes that these Transformers or even toys come in. We don't know. I'm pretty sure this cardboard isn't acid proof, you know? And a lot of these toys that I've realized that people that have kept Transformers or G.I. Joes that have kept them in their box for 30 years, you can tell, you can feel the figure. You can tell that the paint is a little, it feels a little rough on the back when it's been touching the cardboard, or there's a slight difference in color. A lot of people will argue that. Rick, well, because that was, you know, who knows, it was probably put in the sun, but I don't want to take my chance, you know. It could be right, either that's sun fading, or it could be, you know, maybe it was in the water, who knows. But comic book goers, us comic book collectors, we know paper and acid don't mix. Well, there's stickers, there's rubber, there's paint. Keeping it touching certain acid type products in another 30 years, who knows where it's going to be, you know, if it's going to start to fade or dissolve. Anyways, my main emphasis of this, me telling you this story, is I just like to preserve. And plus, whenever I have friends or whenever I take these to conventions, I don't want people's hands, you know, maybe they scratch their butt cheek, or maybe they're eating a burrito and don't want to put beans on it. Who knows? And with the plastic or the Mylar, it'll preserve that. So people can take it out of the box, take a look. Oh yeah, the stickers are nice and neat and so forth. And that's why I keep them. And once I get my collector case or my display case, guys, I'm probably going to show them off. I'm not going to take them out of the bag, but I'll probably put the whole box in there and just, you know, have them displayed with the vehicle in the box, just like that. It displays nice and neat. And again, the window is a thicker type Mylar, so I don't know. I'm going to do some investigating, guys, maybe replacing the Mylar. This seems to be like a 4 mil type of Mylar window, or at least a plastic sheet. I don't know. Maybe good for a different video for later on, you know. Who knows? Anyways, next thing I picked up, guys, the last thing, guys, I want to show you, I'll try to speed through this, is this G.I. Joe Zanzibar. It's not mint in box, it's actually opened, but the reason why I picked this up, again, was because I remember getting this for a birthday of mine when I was like 6 or 7 years old. And I actually have a picture, I tried looking for that picture to show you guys in this video, I can't find it. And there's a picture of me playing with my cousins in the background, and this toy is sitting on top of a table unopened still, just sitting there in the foreground of that video. And I'm like, hey, I remember that. So anyways, because I have that picture, when I saw this today, I'm like, I had to buy it. I had to buy it. So, of course, Zanzibar, for all you guys, he is a dreadnought, one of kind of the later dreadnoughts that came aboard later on, not your original ones, but he did come with this nice looking, I want to say like an air skiff, it says it is. He sits on it and I guess he flies, but I remember my original one, I would put it in water and try to get it to float, and it would never float, of course, but I remember getting mad. But anyways, it's a pretty nice, you know, it's complete. It has its two weapons. It has its little Thor looking hammer and his spear. Stickers look nice. It is a little dusty. I'll probably clean it up. But like I was mentioning earlier, it's missing its window. This, let me take it out. It's not sealed, or at least it has been removed, the G.I. Joe. He just sits in the original kind of protective case there, which is pretty cool. And then also it has his original instruction sheet, or his blueprints, his plastic, I forgot what you call it, where you keep all the missiles and the little guns. He has his original gun there too. Oops, sorry about that hiccup, guys. I ran out of space on my memory stick, so I had to delete some. But that just tells me I better hurry up. This video's gone long enough. Anyways, like I was mentioning, this Zanzibar comes with its original, you know, little inserts that it comes with too. Plus its little, this mailer catalog that you can send in five proof of purchases, and then plus a dollar in order to obtain, or at least to be sent, this fridge action figure, this G.I. Joe. I remember that. I remember it. I never did it, but I remember it. And that's pretty much it, guys. So this is everything that I picked up for the past 2 weeks, and expect another video out probably, I'm hoping, Wednesday, maybe Thursday, with an update on regarding my G.I. Joe and Transformer project that I'm going to be doing. Hopefully a lot of you collectors out there, you know, can take a look, check it out. Don't want to say too much, but expect that video coming out. Again, guys, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, hit me up, let me know. Thanks for watching. I know this video went a little long, but thanks for sticking out to those who actually watched the whole thing. Again, guys, take it easy. Peace out.